In this video, we're going to solve some proportion problems. I have three different problems, and we also have three different methods. So I'm going to do one problem with each method, and you can see which one you like the best. And also, you might want to use certain methods in certain situations. So one method might be easier in a certain situation than another. So the first one is a visual method, or called scaling, and I'm very visual. So if you're visual like me, this might be really helpful. A car speeding on the highway in cruise control travels 18 miles every 15 minutes. Okay, so we've got 18 miles every 15 minutes. How far will the car travel in 5 minutes? Okay, and notice they're telling us it's in cruise control. So that's a way of saying we have a constant speed. So these quantities should be proportional. We're not going to be going, you know, speeding up and slowing down, because then that would be different, right? And then we also want to know how far will it travel in 1 hour. Okay, so to visualize this, I have a bar that goes all the way across the page. And on the very left side, I have 0 miles at the top and 0 minutes at the bottom, because those correspond. In 0 miles, you're going to go 0 minutes, right? Or 0 minutes, 0 miles. And then in at the top, a little bit, maybe a quarter of the way down the bar, I have 18 miles on the top over 15 minutes. So the car travels 18 miles every 15 minutes, and then I have that part of the rectangle shaded in. Okay, so we can use this to scale as long as it kind of goes in evenly, or we have nice numbers. This is a good method for this. Or you can use it to kind of visualize how you would do the math, and then do the division that way, or whatever operation it ends up being. So 15 minutes, we need to think about how can we get that to 5 minutes. Okay, so it's definitely smaller, so it's going to go over to the left. And I have 0 to 15, well, that's really like a third, right? So if I count by fives, 5, 10, 15. So I'm going to kind of mark every third, 0, 5, 10, 15. And then we're going to mark the same on the top of the bar. We need to cut this 18 into thirds as well, okay? So you might know that in your head. Or you can do 18 divided by 3 and you get 6. So we have at the top 6, and if we count by 6s, we have 6, 12, 18. Okay, so this is great, because now we can see that 5 minutes corresponds to 6 miles. Okay, so I'm going to write that down for the first part of our question. The car will travel 6 miles in 5 minutes, right? And that's because we're saying it's a constant speed, so these quantities are proportional to each other. Okay, so now let's try, how far will it travel in 1 hour? Now we need to think about 15 again. Let's go to 15. We could use the 5 if we wanted, but let's go think about 15 minutes. How do we get to 1 hour? Okay, well, if you think on a clock, 15 is a quarter of an hour, right? So we're going to need to go we're going to have 4 of these pieces. So I'm going to go try to estimate about the same width. That would be another 15. You can actually go write the numbers as you go if you want. So 30, then 45 minutes. Then 60 minutes, or 1 hour. Okay, so this time we're scaling up versus scaling down. Now we need to do the same thing with 18. I'm not as good with my 18s, so let's try, you might know 18 times 2. I think it's 36, yeah. So 18, 36, plus another 18, or you could multiply it by 3, is 54, plus another 18 is 72. Okay, so this car is traveling 72 miles in 1 hour. Okay, so I hope they're not speeding too much, but it could be on the highway. The car will travel 72 miles in 1 hour. And of course, we could also think of that as a rate, which is or 72 miles per hour. And you often see this abbreviation, right? Miles per hour, where the per is the P in there. Okay, great. So that's how we can solve a proportion problem using a visual or by scaling. Here we're kind of, we were going scaling by a third and then we were multiplying by four. Let's try another method. Let's try one where we solve using a unit rate or constant multiple. Okay, so this one says bars of soap are on sale at the price of 3 bars for $2. Okay, how much would you pay for 7 bars of soap if the sale applies to all quantities at the same rate? And again, this is important information because often if you buy more, you get a better price. But in this case, they're telling us it's the same rate. Okay, so we're going to use a unit rate. And that works really well for prices. Often you're trying to find the unit rate so you can compare and see which is better. But here we're going to use it to find out the price for 7 bars. So again, I mentioned this in the last video, it helps me to figure out the units first. I want dollars per bar. Okay, so I'm gonna write out my units. I'm gonna put dollars per bar, and that tells me which way I want to divide. Now you could do it the other way, but this is the most intuitive way for me. So if we have dollars per bar, then we have $2 per 3 bars, okay? And I'm going to divide that. I can see it's 2/3, 2 divided by 3, so it's 0.67 cents, so 67 cents, because we would round it to the cents hundredth place. 0.67 per bar. So that's my unit rate. Or another way you could write that is 67 cents per bar. And the dollar comes before and the cent symbol comes after. Okay, so we've got our unit rate, but now what we really want to know is 7 bars, right? So for 7 bars. The great thing about this is we multiply this by 7 because we've got 7. So I'm going to take 7, and it can help to put the units on here, so I'm going to do that, times 0.67 dollars per 1 bar. The reason I'm writing it out as a fraction is just to show you how the units are going to cancel. If I wrote it out you know, horizontally, that's fine too, but I'm just doing it to show you how the units cancel, and then we end up with dollars. So if I do 7 times 0.67, I get 469. Okay, for 7 bars. Okay. Now you may, we rounded this, so if I did 7 times 2/3, it might get a slightly different answer. 7 times 2/3, we wouldn't have this round off error, so we would get 4.67. So either one is okay, that's why you show your steps, and either one is really correct. So I would pay $4.69 or $4.67, depends on how, which way the store calculates it, for 7 bars of soap. Okay, great. So we didn't use a visual there, but we could have. Instead, this time we found a unit rate and then we multiplied it by the number of bars we had. Okay, so that's our second method. Let's look at our third method. Solving proportion problems with an algebraic equation. Now, if you are familiar with algebra or like algebra, you may be more familiar with this method, and you're welcome to use it if you like it. If you don't like it, you don't have to use it. So proportions with an algebraic equation. Let me show you how this is going to work. So a house valued at $480,000 has property taxes of $4,992 per year. Okay. In the same neighborhood, assuming the tax rate is proportional, What would the property taxes be for a house valued at $395,000? Okay, so this is going back to one of the, kind of related to one of the examples at the very beginning. This is property taxes, and it should be proportional to the house's value, but it might depend on the area. And certainly different states might be different. So we know the thing about these, we always know three things and we're trying to find the fourth one, right? So we have one pair goes together and then we have one of the other and we're trying to find the fourth thing. So you can set this up in a few different ways. I'm going to put the two things I know together and then I'm going to put the thing that's missing, I'm going to label with an X, okay? So I'm going to put the tax, also the thing that, to make this easier to solve, I want to actually put the X first. I'm going to do it differently than I just told you. The easiest way to solve it is if the X is in the upper left. So I'm going to do that. And this is what we're trying to find. What would the property taxes be for a house valued at $395,000? Okay, so this is my tax. And then that goes with this value, which is $395,000. So that's my tax and that's my value. Okay, now I need to make sure that those match up on the other, in the other rate or ratio over here. So I'm gonna put my tax on top, which is gonna be the $4,992 per year. And the value of the house is $480,000. Okay, now you can flip this upside down or left to right and it's still equal, but just to make it easier to solve, it is nice to have the X in the top at least on either side. Okay, so now this is an algebraic equation. We're saying this ratio is equal to that ratio, and that's what it means to be proportional. They have the same rate or ratio. So to solve this, we want to get the X by itself. We want to isolate the X. And since it's on the top, I need to undo, or wherever it is, I need to undo the operation that's being done to it. So I'm dividing by this number, so I need to multiply both sides of this equation by that number, essentially to undo this division and isolate the X. Okay, so I'm gonna multiply, I'm gonna have to write it up here because I didn't leave myself much room. I'm gonna multiply by that on this side, the left side, and also multiply it on the right side. Okay, so the ones on the left will cancel out, and that will leave me with X equals. And then I'm going to go ahead and multiply and divide on the right side. So on the right side, I didn't put my dollar sign here. You can see these two dollar signs will cancel and we'll end up with dollars. I'm going to take the 4992 times and multiply fractions straight across, 395,000, so 000, divided by 480,000. And we get $4,108. Yes. Okay, so the house is valued at $395,000 would have property taxes of $4,108 per year. Okay, so that method was using an algebraic equation. Now you can still solve it if the X is in the denominator, but you just have to multiply both sides by X and then to get it in the top, and you just have more division, just have more steps to do. But if you like to do it that way, you can do it. So these were three different methods. You could, if you want, you could try the other ones with the other methods. You could, you know, we used one method for each, but you could do all three for each one if you wanted to, and you should come out with the same answer. So try these out, and I'll see you in the next video.